Hello guys, Bobashik here, and today I want to show you the first clips of Feral Druid Holy Paladin in Season 3. We have already played the placement games and we're going right into it. Against Unholy Decay, Holy Paladin. We open on the Holy Paladin somewhat fast, still get knocked out unfortunately by the disease of the Death Knight. And I start casting a Cyclone really early because I notice instantly that the Paladin pops his wings offensively and the Death Knight is about to pop his Abomination. So I think it Cyclone the Holy Paladin, casting a Reclone on the Holy Paladin because I thought the Holy Paladin would drink it, and I kind of want to force the AMS of the Death Knight, which we get right here. Get the AMS. Paladin thing is the second Cyclone, so the DR one. My Paladin is taking a lot of damage. I taunt him as well at this point, and I'm ready to pop my my Blood of the Enemy. Pop my Berserk, start some pressure, brutal slashing, getting the bleeds up. As you can see here as well, my Paladin is dropping really low. Still not bubbling. I kick the Paladin here on his cast, and you see he's like dropping really low. Tank Trinket procs, pops his Avenging Light, I Warstop him, and I clone him really low as well. At this point, I just want to maintain the bleeds on the Death Knight because I realize I cannot actually force more out of the Paladin than we just did. I mean, he popped his Aura Mastery, he popped his wings, forced the Trinket as well, he has no Hodge. So we just clone him, get the bleeds running on the Death Knight, try to make him drop really low, focus on the Holy Paladin, and then I kick him here as well. 7%. Just not enough damage to actually finish him. And at this point, quite unlucky, my Holy Paladin actually got the Aura Mastery off with the Blood of Saz, so the Paladin was actually forced to bubble. Didn't have my kick ready just yet. Just keeping the damage up, huge pressure, taunts my Holy Paladin, so the Death Knight takes more damage. They wanna go me, no problem. I chase the Death Knight, the Holy Paladin even, bash him full, Ferocious Bite, and we actually get the first kill out of the placement games. The MMR is 1900-ish after the placement game, so it's nothing too bad. Next up, we're facing Restle Druid Windwalker Monk. Windwalker Monks are fairly common, I feel like. I faced plenty of these, even today. Lot of damage, lot of peels. Definitely one of the better classes in 2v2. Open on the Monk, full bleeds. They want to go me, and I kind of want to tunnel the Restle Druid here. Blood Frenzy, Blood Enemy popped. Even though he pops his Ring of Peace, I still want to get my bleeds up and damage as much as possible. As you can see, I jump forward, getting the bleeds up nonetheless, get knocked back, no problem, to just get the most value out of this all. Ferocious Bite him. He pops Stones, so I swap off him now, because Stones is 5% of your HP per hit it actually does, so it's a huge, huge defensive from them, and it does way too much damage on me. So I swap on the Monk. Full bleeds. There's a chance I'll get leg stripped, but I do not mind. I taunt my Paladin, so he swaps me. Happens. I kick the Cyclone, taunt is off the Restle Druid, as you can see as well. I root him, so I can connect. And here it's interesting. I get bashed, and instead of trinketing instant to maintain my momentum, I kind of want to be the art on clone first, so I get cloned, trinket insta, swapping back onto him, popping my damage, and we force Iron Bark. Swapping back to the Monk, maiming the Monk full, hoping to get a trinket off. Not really happening. Force Bite to maintain the bleeds. He pops Voidstone on this Monk for some odd reason, and he popped Wall as well. I guess he was a bit scared because he used his Karma offensively to reflect Thorns damage, that because I used Thorns on my Holy Paladin, and he used his Touch of Death already. At this point I want to go to the Druid again. I leap kick him. He leaps away, try to clone him, nothing big. Don't want to get hit by that Fist of Fury, it's a lot of damage from the Windwalker. Chasing the Druid, and you can see here he wants the War Stomp, I dodge it, avoid the Cyclone, chasing him again. Maintaining those bleeds on him, he pops Thorns again, instantly back on the Monk. Doesn't have Flex Sweep ready for 4 seconds, you can see right here. He does have Bash, trying to kite the Fist of Fury. Faked my kick, so it's not really the best kick I could have done. Druid could have cloned me here if he wanted to, but they decided to swap to me. Barks is Windwalker Monk, which is like really good for us, so we can maybe force out a trinket. He has no Barks skin either. So I cycle on Druid first. Ring of Peace himself, really good. Go on the Druid then. I get bashed full, quite unlucky. Blood Frenzy going. I shift the Hibernate. This gives me the chance to kick the Cyclone. rooted through it so I can connect. Blood of the enemy popped, doing that damage. Chasing. Then I realize I can might get a restuff here. I'm getting it. Turret wants it reopened because he just got off stun DR as well. Quite some damage going. Taunts on the turret, not the best. Decides to stop casting. I kinda hit into taunts on this one. To then hibernate him full. And then I'm like, okay, he's DR on stuns, but I can still get a clean opener on him again. Reopen on him. Leading up the monk. Tiger's Fury, leaping with the travel form, chasing a bit, full blitz on the monk with Tiger's Fury at least. Bit of a misplay here, I had 3 combo points and I froze Spire the Druid because I wanted to refresh my rip, but the rip was literally like a second off. So trying to reapply that rip ASAP without the Tiger's Fury though. Innovate from the Druid, so I kind of want to tunnel him so he doesn't get too many casts off. Still gets that regrowth though. Root the monk a bit. Taunts myself, so they don't really want to go me, because my paladin still has bubble and all the defenses. Touch of death, I trinket it. Quite some damage. He voidstoned the damage. As you can see here, I had voidstone for just a second by the paladin to absorb that huge touch of death damage, because my paladin was quite lucky. He got it in the pre-season 3 week, you could say. He got the voidstone and some nice PvE gear, so we can somewhat do okay against Windwalker monks, even though it's like a really hard matchup for us, I feel like. I feral charged through the vortex, so I didn't get completely soaked back, and this puts me, I think, in a weird DR spot, because he gets hodged, and then he drops Ring of Peace, but I think, because I don't understand really why, because I haven't never experienced this, I didn't get knocked by the Ring of Peace here, because I went through the vortex, so I think I DR'd myself on the knock. I'm not quite sure about it, and I was actually just able to kill the druid into the bash, into the ferocious bite. So a bit of an awkward ending, but I mean, we were like really, well shit, I still had 2 walls and everything. Get my combatant title here, so that was the 400 marker, 2k MMR, nothing too bad, I'm quite satisfied with it. Next up we're facing Demon Hunter Wrestle Druid. Demon Hunter is quite common as well, faced a few of them. This is also around 2k MMR, and we kinda wanted to kill the Demon Hunter here. But it's really hard to decide. We felt like, yeah, how we should play this comp. Should we CC? Should we bleed both of them? So we tried on the Druid first to see what happens. I think it quite offensively the stun from the Demon Hunter. The Druid taunts himself, so I cyclone him. Somewhat lowish. Bleeding up the DH. Going back on the Druid, because Storm's about to end anyway. I get bashed. I will get cycloned. He actually bobs the bash, so I have a chance to kick it. Really good. The offensive bobs. Not kicking Tranquility, because there's no point. Because you know he will only go for that one tick. And here you see as well that he's casting a Hibernate. I do not shift out of it, because he wants me to shift out of it, so the game can like start. Some Druids will cast Hibernate, want you to shift out, so they can recast it, and by the time you shift back in, you have to shift out again, so you actually lose DPS. So I didn't care, hold my kick, not kicking, just doing damage as much as possible. Full maim, getting quite some damage, even though he has like quite a lot of stacks. I clone the Druid here, going on the DH a bit, gets hodged, really good for us. Doing the bleeds again, trying to maintain those, trying to see what is the best thing we can do. He taunts, he melts, doesn't get the rakes on off, instantly chases me. Gets the mana burn off, quite unlucky. I clone the DH here on his blade dance. Trying to keep the druid in combat so he doesn't get drinks off, because we know that in deep dampening, if druid has the mana for it, they probably will win this match. Even though the DH is actually mana burning my paladin constantly, my paladin plays with the lucid dream, so it returns mana, like 50% chance I think per spell cast. So my partner's mana is doing really well. The druid is looking for drinks but not really getting them. I taunt myself here because I want the druid to actually take damage if he wants to damage me in cat form. Cyclone him somewhat low. Low as in 70%, not that low. Doing some damage on the DH. I get stunned here. Druid is not going for that drink. I would have done that in his place. Get DR'd stunned, so it's an awkward choice by him. I drop a little bit below, but I'm not really too fast about it. I bash him here. cloning the druid. He bashes me, I don't mind. It's triple DR, he's wasting his bashes. I get maledicted. I drop somewhat low here as well. I kick the cyclone so he doesn't get the re. It's doing the damage. Couldn't get the hymenate off. I get kicked. So in this way, like, I tried to hymenate the druid even though I knew he would shift out. The DH actually kicked it. So my paladin could actually cast out of this clone. He has the bubble, unfortunately, and sacked me. So it's alright. Kick the druid here on the cyclone. Full bleeds on the druid. The matchup is taking fairly long, just mainly because we're bleeding two tasks at this point. So it's we're kind of just figuring out how we should play this. Or against this, rather. Doing some damage. Do some big damage on the druid here. You can see the iron bark. The darkness is popped as well. Cyclone the druid. Cyclone at 50%. Because I have literally nothing. But I see my paladin is dropping really low as well. Because he uses stun offensively. He's bubble offensively in. Either. Get vortexed. Maintain the bleeds. And I see the druid kind of wants to go for a sip. And you can see it right here. And I tell my paladin, yeah, I can't really reach it. So my paladin actually gets the judgment off. Really good. Stop the drink. Hibernating. Make him shift. Cyclone after. Trigger the incap. Again, not that great. Because now I get full stunned. Druid still in a cyclone though. So he can't really follow up. I taunt my paladin. So the DH actually takes extra damage. Druid, bad kick by me. I kicked here. Because I thought I actually would be able to make it. Now still a bit too much out of range. So I get full cloned. But my paladin is completely stable. So we're chilling. Full maim on the DH. Chasing the druid a little bit at this point. Because we feel like he's like the weak link. And it's easier to kill. The DH self-healing is actually like so much. Like the druid is barely healing him. Taunts on the druid. Taunts on him still. But cycloning. He melts. I have more haste. I win the cyclone battle. Easy. Druid is full cycloned. Don't want him to go to drink, so I keep him in combat. Maintaining the bleeds. Maintaining the pressure. Swapping to the HBD. Trying to peel. Not sure what I'm doing here. I'm just fucking circles. Bash the DH on the stun. My paladin, telling my paladin he can run a little bit. Taunts on myself. Actually going for my... Then here, you can see it. You can see that they're both going for my Holy Paladin. And he's dropping really low. So he gets bashed. I see that. So first of all, I clone the druid. Why do I clone the druid? Because the druid still has trinket. And I want him at least to waste his trinket at this point. Then I start. And after this stun, I clone the age. Because he incapped my partner. And he wants to mana burn it. So I clone the age. He has no trinket. Kick the cyclone as well. Recasting the clone on the DH. Maim on the druid. Taunts on the druid at this point. Kind of hitting it a bit too much. I shouldn't have done that. Feral Frenzy. Bit of a misplay. I could have actually just raked one combo point rip and then Feral Frenzy into Ferocious Bite. Because now I kind of wasted Feral Frenzy to do damage. So the DH actually melts. Pretty good. Full clone him now. No trinket. No trinket for either of them at this point. So trying to keep the druid in combat. Oh, and unfortunately I bashed at the same time with the Hodge. Bad communication by us. He called out his Hodge earlier than I did. And in my mind I had like, yeah, I have to bash him. So bit unlucky. The blaster coming out from my Holy Paladin. Vortex out. Trying to outrun it. Taunts on myself so he doesn't actually go for me. But should have probably used on the Paladin because I still have two walls and a trinket. Maintaining the damage on the druid. It's quite ironic because the DH is doing the same DPS as I am, even though I'm bleeding two targets pretty much constantly. Cyclone DH. Chasing the druid so he doesn't get his mana. Running back because I don't want to chase him too far. I want to be able to peel. My paladin calls out was fine, so I can still chase. So I am. He barks. I don't mind, I'm going through. Dampening is really high at this point. You see, like, all 7 minutes have passed. I'm incapped, really happy with that, because the druid might be able to kill me. Chasing, Moonfire to keep him in combat. At this point I call out, okay, my paladin hodges the DH. I have my Predator Swiftness proc, so I call, okay, start running, I can root him full. Yes, door, yes, reverse magic, but I don't really care. He's not using it. I get bashed. Still get the kick. He faked it, doing damage. And here you see the edge coming after, even though I could have reversed magic. Darkness, but it doesn't matter. It's a long matchup. It's fairly hard. We don't really know how to counter it yet, even though we played today some games as well, and we felt like playing with Repentance as a feral druid is like the best approach, we feel like, because bleeding two targets just takes so damn long. Even though my paladin had like 60-70% mana, we just run out of CDs after a while. So yeah, these were like the first games of the season after the placement games. The placement games are just, yeah, deciding your MMR. We were like at 2k, I think we stranded somewhere at 2.1 MMR at one point. Then I started playing Resto Druid Warlock, which will be a future video that I'll be making. Feral looks okay on paper, but compared to like Windwalker Monks and the Ages, as you can see, the guy is telling my Holy Paladin to Oblivion, 8k DPS, and I'm bleeding somewhat, constantly two targets and only doing like 9k DPS. Even though my rotation wasn't on point this game, I felt like that without the burst that we have with Blood of the Enemy and the Berserk, we kind of lack sustainable damage. Anyway, I hope you liked this video, and I hope you will be looking forward to the next one. Bye bye.